Your Honor, opposing counsel, members of the jury, it came down to experience. The defendant, Chase Covington, he had to make one decision, one vote, and it was his. He voted for Ms. Bancroft. It's October 2014, and the Midlands Gambling Commission, and they announced that they will be accepting proposals for a license to put up a new casino in the state of Midlands. Chase Covington, being the chair of the Gambling Commission, reviewed these proposals for months. But when it came to voting day, April 17th, 2015, it became a race between two candidates, Ms. Avery Bancroft and Ms. Shannon Stark. So on voting day, Mr. Chase Covington, he voted for the best candidate. He voted for the one that had the most experience. It's that simple. He had a decision. He voted. He voted for Ms. Bancroft. But now the state, and they want you to believe that Chase Covington accepted money in exchange for voting for Ms. Bancroft. Members of the jury, they want you to believe that the day before the vote, on April 16, 2015, the defendant walked into Ms. Bancroft's casino, walked into the VIP room with a briefcase, and before he left, they want you to believe that they exchanged briefcases. And that briefcase was $200,000. But members of the jury, while you're listening to the evidence in today's trial, not one single witness that takes that stand today will be able to tell you that they saw an exchange of briefcases take place. Now we as the defense, we do not have to prove our client's innocence. And that burden of proof lies solely with this table. The state, they must prove to you three elements beyond a reasonable doubt. Those three elements are, one, that my client, Chase Covington, is a public official. Two, that Chase Covington received money. And three, that when he received this money, he had the intent to be influenced by that money to vote for Ms. Avery Bancroft. Members of the jury, they have to prove this to you beyond a reasonable doubt, each and every element. Now, when I say beyond a reasonable doubt, that simply means that after hearing all the evidence, all the facts that come out in today's trial, you cannot have any doubts based upon your own common sense or reason. But members of the jury, the state, they will not be able to prove this burden. Today, the defense, they will be calling three witnesses before you to tell you exactly what happened the day before the vote. First, we will call the head of security at the Black Bear Casino, Danny Hoy. Danny Hoy will take this stand today, and she will tell you that she was working on April 16, 2015. And in that casino, on her watch, she never saw Mr. Chase Covington accept money from Ms. Bancroft. She never saw them exchange briefcases. There were no reports of an exchange. No one saw this bribe take place. Next, we'll call Ollie Thomas. Ollie Thomas is a blackjack dealer that works at the casino, the Black Bear. He will tell you that Chase Covington and Avery Bancroft sat at his blackjack table where this supposed bribe took place. He will tell you about how they played their game and there was no switch of briefcase. At no point did he ever see Chase Covington accept any money from Avery Bancroft. Lastly, we will call Chase Covington himself. He will take the stand and he will tell you about the events leading up to the vote. He will tell you how this really came down to two candidates. And in the end, Ms. Bancroft, she simply had the most experience. That's why he voted for her. He will tell you about the day, April 16, 2015, how he did go to that casino, but there was no switch of briefcases. There was no money exchange. Members of the jury, it is clear that it just came down to experience. Thank you.
Okay, thank you.